Birla Global University. A state private university in a green and non-toxic campus with a global pedagogy backed by the Birla legacy and celebrating the varied cultural diversities to create ethical global leaders. Welcome to Birla Global University. A state private university in a green and non-toxic campus with a global pedagogy backed by the Birla legacy and celebrating the varied cultural diversities to create ethical global leaders. Welcome to Birla Global University. A state private university in a green and non-toxic campus with a global pedagogy backed by the Birla legacy and celebrating the varied cultural diversities to create ethical global leaders. Welcome to Birla Global University. A state private university in a green and non-toxic campus with a global pedagogy backed by the Birla legacy and celebrating the varied cultural diversities to create ethical global leaders. Welcome to Birla Global University.
कौन करिए
द चीफ गेस्ट हैज अराइव्ड सो आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू स्विच ऑफ योर फोन सो काइंडली कीप इट इन साइलेंट मोड
A state private university in a green and non-toxic campus with a global pedagogy backed by the Birla legacy and celebrating the varied cultural diversities to create ethical global leaders. Welcome.
Honorable dignitaries, esteemed guests, respected parents, members of media, and my friends and juniors. Martin Luther King has very aptly asserted, "Take the first step in faith. You don't have to see the whole staircase. Just take the first step."
I, Manashwini,
and I, Kabir,
congratulate you all for taking your first right step towards professionalism. It is an immense pleasure to be given this opportunity of standing before you as a host today.
A very good morning and a warm welcome to the Commencement Day program for BBA Batch 1922 on behalf of the entire family of Birla Global University.
We congratulate each one of you on having secured a place in this Birla School of Management BGU.
It is our enormous pleasure to have such eminent guests amongst us today. Mr. Chandrasekhar Mukherjee, Chief People Officer, South Indian Bank, as the chief guest. Mr. Parag Diwan, Chief Executive Officer, Paradigm Consultants and Resource Management Private Limited, as the guest of honor. Professor Dr. Sudhakar Panda, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Birla Global University. Dr. Sarat Acharya, National Professor and Advisor, Birla Global University. Professor Dr. B.K. Das, Registrar, Birla Global University, and finally, Professor Dr. Parmeshwar Nayak, Dean, Birla School of Management, Birla Global University. May we now humbly request our guests and other dignitaries to kindly come up to the dais and kindly be seated. I request our student volunteers to welcome our guests on behalf of the entire family of Birla Global University.
Thank you. Life symbolizes knowledge and success. One of the best gifts you can give to yourself is to discover the light within you. So let us now light the lamp of wisdom in the powerful reverberation of the holy Saraswati Vandana to dispel the darkness of ignorance by the dawn of self-realizations. May I now request our esteemed guests to light the lamp and inaugurate the commencement day. Sir, please.
Shubhavastramrutam, ya veena varam.
Thank you, everyone. I now take this opportunity of introducing our Dean, Birla School of Management, Professor Dr. Parmeshwar Nayak. Dr. Nayak is an ardent professor in human resource management, an academic administrator, a corporate trainer, a management consultant, and a professional social worker. He has about 30 years of work experience in teaching, academic administration, training, research, and consultancy, including about 19 years in leadership positions such as director and dean in the leading B schools such as BIMTech, Bhubaneswar, Amity University, Noida, KIT University, ITS Institute of Management, Greater Noida. Besides his services at Delhi University, XIMB, and BCT IIHMR, Jaipur. He is a trained trainer with training received from IIMs, XIMB, IIPA, ISHA, and IIHMR. He has conducted over 300 training and MDPs for executives of more than 25 public and private companies like NTPC, NLC, RSP or SAIL, RBI, etc. He has been invited by a number of universities and institutes of repute in India, Slovenia, Tanzania, Nepal, USA, UK, and Oman as visiting professor, resource person, and keynote speaker at international conferences. He has completed 23 consultancy research assignments sponsored by DFID, Government of UK, USID, KfW Germany, Interact Worldwide, London, CRS, UNDP, Government of India, NRHM. He has worked for Adam Smith Institute as Project Director Social Safety Net Program under DFID-funded public sector program of the Government of Odisha. He has been an international research guide for 4 international interns under UNICEF KCCI internship program in 2019. He has received National HR Excellence Award in the category Best Management Education Leadership Award 2018 from National Institute of Personal Management, Elvina the Luke Award of Delhi University 1989, Chhatra Gaurav Samman Award from FM College 2019, besides Doctoral Fellowship from ICSSR, UGC's Junior Research Fellowship with NET qualification. His publications include 2 books and several research papers besides his doctoral guidance. He is a life member of professional bodies like ISTD, ISTE, SSAI. He is a member of Knowledge Committee of PhD Chamber of Commerce, New Delhi, and a member of Executive Committee of NHRDN, Bhubaneswar Chapter, and the ISTD's Testing and Certification Committee. He has been invited as assessor of HR best practices in companies for the award of national level professional bodies such as NIPM. He has been invited as expert panelist in international, national and regional TV channels such as Bloomberg, NDTV, Doordarshan and News World Odia TV. Dr. Nayak is an alumnus of Delhi University. He is a postgraduate and PhD in personal management and industrial relations. He has been instrumental in setting up of 2 rural hospitals, one in Rajasthan and another one in Odisha. He is also an active Rotarian. I would request Dean, School of Management, Birla Global University, Dr. Parmeshwar Naik, to kindly deliver the welcome address. Sir, please.
Very good morning to all of you. I need a little louder response. Good morning. Yes. Esteemed Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sudhakar Panda, our very honorable guest, chief guest, Mr. Chandrasekhar Mukherjee, our guest of honor, Dr. Parag Diwan, Professor Sarath Acharya, our national professor and advisor of BGU, our registrar, Dr. B.K. Das, our dean of School of Commerce, Professor Samson Moharana, our controller examination, Dr. B.C. Misra, Professor, Honorable Professor from IIT Kharagpur, Dr. Ashok Panda in the audience, my dear faculty colleagues, parents, and dear students. I deem it as a special privilege for me and at the same time my pleasure to extend a very warm welcome to all of you present in this auspicious occasion. My special thanks and welcome goes to our revered chief guest, Mr. Chandrasekhar Mukherjee, who is a very accomplished HR professional in the country. As our guest, chief guest today, I, who can be better person than him, for the students of BBA. Somebody who has served the corporate sector more than three decades and has been in the top position. We are very fortunate to have you, sir. Thank you very much for accepting our invitation and coming over here. I am sure all of you will be waiting for a kind of deliberation that he is going to give to you. Dr. Parag Diwan is a very eminent educationist in the country who has been founder vice chancellor of UPES, Dehradun, and he is advisor to many educational institutions. He is a very successful edupreneur. And we are very fortunate to have you as guest of honor in this function. Our national professor, Professor Sarath Kumar Acharya, is no less important person who has retired as chairman and managing director of very, you know, well-known PSU, Navratan company called NLC India Limited. He has been in top positions in HR domain before joining as CMD of NLC India. We are very fortunate to have him immediately after his retirement as national professor and advisor in our Birla Global University. Welcome to this program, sir. Our vice chancellor is part of the whole system. He is part of this function, but I have a special pleasure as a Dean of the School of Management to welcome you, sir, to this function. Our registrar is a pillar of foundation of this particular university. I have a special pleasure of welcoming you, sir, to this function of this Birla School of Management. I stop here for a moment because I looked at my students in good number. Number is increasing every year. The School of Management. Many professors who are part of us, who are really pillars. So many, we have about 200 plus pillars in our universities that, you know, helped us registering from this cyclone that we had recently. Our building is less affected because of very strong pillar. And our university is growing because of our strong pillars, their faculty members. Each and every person, whether they are teaching faculty or non-teaching professionals, they are so dedicated people. I have a special pleasure of welcoming all of you present here and also those people who are working out of this hall for, you know, making your stay comfortable. Very special welcome to newly admitted students of BBA, both in the BBA Honors course, BBA Digital Marketing, BBA Business Analytics, to this August gathering. This is a very special day for you. Anything that begins well also can give you a lot of boost, a lot of energy to continue and end well. And I'm sure anything which begins must have a very strong goal to achieve. And all of you present here might have come not only to BGU but to this function with a lot of hope, lot of expectations, and you might be having some strong determination to achieve something here. I would just tell you that all of you might be thinking that human beings, we call human beings. To me, human is not a being. Human is a becoming. All of us, God has created all of us to become something. So you all are here today with something that is called becoming. You have many things to do in our life. Each one of you is a talented person. You may be thinking that somebody who has scored 10 CGPA or 9 CGPA is a talented person. For me, each one of you is a talented person. Talent doesn't determine your academic achievement. And all of you should try to have your set your goal on this day, why you have come here. With my 30 years of experience in academics, I have met students who join courses not with a seriousness and without any goal to achieve. They say that, I'll share here one thing which you might have heard from many people, a story that one gentleman was swimming helplessly in a pond because he didn't know how to swim. He was shouting. So many people gathered around the pond and tried to help that person. Suddenly one person jumped to the water and tried to help this. And in the meanwhile, that person who was helpless, he caught him and that both of them could come out of the water. When the gentleman who jumped, plunged into water and saved that person, both of them came out, everybody actually appreciated. You know, they said many good things about him. He was not very happy. He said, we all are saying so many good things about you, you are not happy. He said that, I want to know, I am really searching for the person who pushed me to the water. So the person who perhaps perceived that he went to help that person actually didn't intend to go there. Many of you, how many of you have been pushed like the gentleman to BBA? I hope there should not be not a single hand. It should not be that father told me BBA is a good course, BGU is a good university, go and join. It will make your future. See, you must make your future here. You must set your goal. Many people join, again, in the middle of it, they fizzle out, they try to, you know, change the course. They say that my father said, or my girlfriend has taken the admission, therefore I am here. I am not here because I want to take admission here. Many people change the course because their friend is somewhere else, some other university. Even after 1 year, they also change the university. I think you are not doing that. How to set your goal? I would rather share another anecdote from Quran. I may not like a speech, but I think you will remember this. Once a traveler was roaming around in a country and came to a crossroad. When we are, you know, new traveler in a country, unknown place, what do? And we want to go somewhere, we ask somebody, in India particularly, in a square, you will find pan shop or a shopkeeper, or somebody who passes by, you will ask that person where this road goes and all. The gentleman was searching for someone, human being, to tell him or help him find out the path. But unfortunately, there was no human being, you know, on that particular road to help him out. But there was a big banyan tree. And he was looking around and he got some kind of noise, mew, which is a sound of a cat, a proverbial cat, because it's a story. The proverbial cat was sitting on the in a branch of a tree, that tree, banyan tree, and that was the only creature available at that time. So he was helplessly, you know, asking everywhere where I should go, which the road, this particular road goes to which place, because there are three roads and one road he has already walked through. So he was asking the proverbial cat, this road goes where? The proverbial cat kept quiet. Then again he asked where this left hand side road goes. The cat also remained quiet. He got angry, I am asking you a question. Where this right hand side road goes? Then the cat said, mew. I said, what are you saying? You answer my question. Then the proverbial cat spoke in human language. He said, where do you like to go? The traveler said, I don't know. So cat said, then you can take any road. So the traveler perhaps is just walking and walking, doesn't know where to go. He has no destination. So all of you here must set your destination. You must try to figure out what you want to be. It's not necessary to be a good manager only. After BBA or go to IIM for MBA, all of you may not go. But it doesn't mean that you are not successful. In our life, we need to be successful and also happy. Many times these two things do not go together. Many times we become happy and may not be successful. But in order to be successful, many times we do many unethical things and something which doesn't please you, doesn't make you successful. So what you would like to become? So you have to, I can tell you, so you are not there in other functions. For last 10 days, we are attending many commencement days functions. And I started with saying something C's, either 3 C's or 5 C's. Later on, I found that all other speakers are also saying 3 C's or 3 D's or 2 D's. I said, why we are jumping to C and D? What about A and B? I think I would tell in this function A, B, C, D and conclude my speech. See, we all are living in a VUCA world. How many of you have heard about this word called VUCA? VUCA is not hungry. V-U-C-A. V stands for volatile. U stands for uncertain, C stands for complex, and A stands for ambiguous. So VUCA world is like this. We are living in a very, you know, hyper-tensed, very well-connected, hyper-connected world where you have to really change yourself very fast to live in this kind of VUCA world. One goal that you set today may not be there. You have to reset your goal. So we are living in a world where artificial intelligence, you might have heard, and disruptive technologies are going to be really determining factor in many of our lives, aspects of life. I think today all of us are holding mobile phone in our hand, which is an instrument. After some time, there will be virtual mobile phone, telephone. You just touch or you give your fingerprint, that virtual screen will be visible and you will start working. And all of you might be knowing that artificial intelligence, the hologram and all, I am speaking in English here. If you are Japanese, even I can create hologram and a prototype of my structure will stand and speak in Japanese. That's going to help. Your children, your grandchildren will not come to the BGU classroom like this after some time. They will be studying through some other medium, sitting somewhere, even while traveling, they might be taking the course of some professors. So this is the world that is going to happen. What will remain then special to human being? That's coming A. Whatever machine that human beings may create, whether artificial intelligence, robot, whatever, one thing which will not be from those machines is the attitude. I think Professor Mukherjee, Mr. Mukherjee will agree that in our corporate sector, you may have lot of people with very high, skill and knowledge, but human beings with no right attitude create so much of problem in corporate that HR people, they deal with them. You should have that USP of being human being in the attitude. I'm not going to elaborate further because of paucity of time. B, behavior, the way human beings can behave cannot be replaced by artificial intelligence machine. They can do much faster than you the things you are doing, but the behavior, the change of behavior and different types of behavior, modulation of behavior, all those things will remain special to you. So you have to really develop your attitude, right behavior. And what is the C? There will be five C's you need to have to be successful. First is competencies. Wherever, whatever job you would like to do, develop your competencies well here when you are studying. Second, your communication. See, communication. Without communication, good communication, you will not be successful in your corporate life. Third, your commitment level. You should be committed to your profession and the job that you are going to do. And fourth, you will be consistent in doing whatever you do. People are not consistent what they do. That creates problem. And last but not the least, C is your character. If you have four C's, but the last C is missing, I hope you will be nowhere. What is about the D? Last D, I can tell you, I expect you to give me one D, I will give you back two D's. So three D's are important when you are a student here. And the first D and the billion dollar costly D is the discipline. You become disciplined, rest you leave to us. And what are the two D's we can give you? We will give our life to develop you, development. You have come here to develop yourself. We will try to help you to the maximum possible to develop you the way you want to develop yourself. And last D is that only developing yourself is not enough. We will create both academic and extracurricular activities, non-academic opportunities where you can demonstrate your talents. So I stop here with the hope that all of you should learn. If you are not willing to learn, nobody can help you. But if you are determined to learn, nobody can stop you learn. With these words, I expect you to be a disciplined batch and create a significant, mark in the university, and we should feel proud of having you here. Once again, I welcome all of you, all of our guests, and the distinguished people on the dais of the dais to this beautiful function. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for setting the tone. Next, I have the privilege of reading out the profile of Dr. B.K. Das, Registrar, Birla Global University. Dr. B.K. Das is a PhD in economics and has a diploma in business management along with an LLB to his academic credits. He is also a certified associate of the Indian Institute of Bankers. Dr. Das is a member of the board governors of the university. He represented BIMTEC in the International Banking Conference twice in succession and was instrumental in introducing banking papers in the PGDM and MBA courses in BIMTEC. Dr. Das joined BIMTEC Greater Noida in 2009. Prior to that, he was general manager of a leading public sector bank for more than 6 years, which involved the entire gamut of banking responsibilities. He drafted the vigilance manual of the bank in close coordination with CVC. He also worked as the GM of UCO Bank, New Delhi, for more than 4 years, looking after Delhi, UP, Uttaranchal, Jammu and Kashmir, and a part of Haryana. As GM operations, he was in charge of Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, and a part of Maharashtra. Dr. Das also worked with Professor Yunus, the Nobel laureate, in Bangladesh Grameen Bank under a UNDP project. He was a director in board of West Bengal Industrial Development Corporation. He was also associated with Industrial Finance Corporation of India. He was the chairman of State Level Export Promotion Committee for Odisha and Himachal for 2 years. Was a member of High Powered Committee constituted by the Government of India for Banking Plan for the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Dr. Das has headed the District Industry Center of the Government of Odisha for planning and implementing various central and state programs like entrepreneur development programs, integrated rural development programs, Prime Minister Rozgar Yojana, and promotion of MSMEs. Dr. Das has presented papers in national and international conferences and has edited 2 books, Studies in Management and Indian Banking, the Issues of NPAs. Dr. Das has been instrumental in establishing BIMTEC and Birla Global University. I now request our Honorable Registrar to kindly address the gathering. Sir, please.
Good morning to all of you. Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Panda, Honorable Chief Guest Mr. Mukherjee, Chief People Officer, South Indian Bank, Professor Acharya, Professor Naik, Professor Maharana, Dr. Ashok Panda, my faculty colleagues, and dear students and their parents. This is a historic day in the chapter of BGU. The hall is full. That gives a sense of satisfaction that we have become a matured university. 2013, the first batch of BBA, we had only 10 students. The next batch, we went up to 30 students. Thereafter, it became 50, then 90. So today, I think we are more than 120. And we don't have place to accommodate students, and still there are applications pending. So this gives a feeling of, you know, satisfaction, also a big challenge for us also, because it's a tremendous task on our head, on our shoulder, to take care of large number of students and to maintain the quality of education for which your parents have invested a lot of money to put you here. But I can tell you that we are taking all steps to ensure that there is no disruption on any front. If there is anything, it is purely temporary, and you'll be here with us for 3 years, and 1 week, 2 weeks disruption, I'm sure that you'll manage and you'll take it in a sportive manner, because in your career as a management student, you'll be facing many, many challenges. So this is one of the challenges which we'll face jointly by the university, you are now a part of the university, you are part of the family. So if there is minor hiccups, please
take it as a sportive way and be sure that everything will be done to make you stay here comfortable, and also there will be the academic rigor will be maintained, what has been done for the previous batch. Now, having said this, Professor Nayak, Dean School of Management, who will be taking care of you directly, has told you enough about the management, education, about various challenges before you. I need not go to that. I can only say that please do your job in such a way that we are proud of you, and you also say proudly after many years that I did my BBA from Birla Global University. So that will be the best reward from you to us and by you to the university. So we expect that you will be maintaining the highest standard of discipline, highest standard of students' behavior, and we'll be always eager to help you. Our faculties, non-teaching staffs are always there to help you, and you'll see that everything is forthcoming to make your life comfortable here. But we, as Dr. Nayak said, we expect highest discipline from you and highest type of dedication towards the academics. And you will be free to suggest any additional thing you want in academics, sports, games, whatever is your interest, we'll be ready to implement that here. With this, let me also congratulate Dr. Nayak for having such a big batch under his regime, and it's a big challenge for him also, but it gives a sense of satisfaction that the management, School of Management, is growing in a, galloping way. This is what I wanted to say. I'm not taking much time. My time, thankfully, has been consumed by Dr. Nayak. That made my task easy. And I think it will be, we should give more time to our guests who have come from outside, and you'll be happy to listen to them. Wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for such enriching deliberation. We really feel privileged to introduce Professor Sarat Kumar Acharya, National Professor and Advisor, Birla Global University. Dr. Sarat Kumar Acharya, National Professor and Advisor at Birla Global University. Prior to this, he has served as Chairman and Managing Director of Neyveli Lignite Corporation Limited, NLC, from October 2015 till July 2018. He carries with him rich and varied experience of more than 37 years of working in BAIL, NTPC, NTPC Sale, Power Company, and NLC. Prior to assumption of charge as CMD, he served NLC as Director in Human Resource. Dr. Acharya hails from Odisha and has done his studies in prestigious institutions like Ravenshaw University and Utkal University. In his rich professional career, he made significant contributions for improving people, processes, and practices in companies he worked, and through his innovative management initiatives, strategic and operational interventions, he contributed to the enhancement of business results. A recipient of many national and international awards and honors, Dr. Acharya is one of the few inspirational corporate leaders whose name finds place in the book Most Powerful HR Professionals of India, 4th edition. Widely traveled and well-trained in India and abroad, Dr. Acharya lends his services in academics as well as a visiting faculty to many premier business schools and management institutes. I would now like to invite Professor Sarat Acharya to kindly address the gathering. Sir, please.
Thank you, dear, for all your good words, which I acknowledge with due humility. And here, in fact, on this occasion, I feel it is a privileged association of mine with Birla Global University, esteemed dignitaries on dais, Dr. Panda, our chief guest today, Mr. Chandrasekhar Mukherjee, the guest of honor, Dr. Parag Diwan, our registrar, Professor B.K. Das, and dear friend, Mr. Parmeshwar Naik on the dais, dignitaries of the dais, honorable professors, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, young friends. A very good morning to all of you. In fact, young friends, you come here today and on this commencement day of your bachelor degree course, you carry with you a lot of dreams, your aspirations, your ambitions. And also, you carry with you the dreams of your parents. Parents dream through your eyes. And these are the dreams you don't see while you are sleeping. These are the dreams it comes to you when you think in terms of ambition, aspiration, what you would like to be when you are awake. And naturally you would like to live the dreams. So these are the hope you have come with. And dear friends, growing up is not that easy. Growth, specifically the physical growth, comes to you as you grow in age. But when it comes to development, lot many things are to be done, and most of the things will depend on you, because success in life is 90% hard work and 10% perhaps luck, if there is any. So keeping that in mind, prepare yourself for a long and exciting journey in your life. And dear friends, once I'm talking to you, I know I'm talking to the Gen Y, the millennials, and there is generation gap or generations gap. I was talking to my daughter herself is doing a PhD, and we were discussing about generation gap, and she told, Papa, it is not the gap of one generation, perhaps lot many staircases are missing. The way things have moved over the years, the rapid changes. We grew up in a period when we didn't have the access to the internet, to television even, very few, maybe black and white, and the source of knowledge was from books, listening to our teachers, our parents, older people, and you people have exposure to many things, good things in life, internet, the entire world coming in a manner of convergence through this net and the Facebook, social media, and of course the artificial intelligence. So the fourth revolution, the IT revolution and the knowledge revolution that is happening, and you have access to Google, and in fact for people like you who have developed the habit of using the Google, and also in the Lou, we in a lighter way call them not only the Googlers, they are the Luglers. So your expectations naturally would be different, but keep in mind one thing, this growth happening, even the physical growth also, if you would like to have a balanced growth, you will have to develop yourself, keep good physique through exercises, through good food, balanced food, should I say, the diet, and so far the development of mind is concerned, keep yourself agile and always eager to learn. And the process of learning, as we know, for you, it is not basically we, the professors or the academic fraternity, it is all open. You have to be very receptive to the ideas. And what Dr. Nayak told, the discipline of learning, the discipline of observing the good things has to be there in you. And always keep in mind that the optimism always helps, because at least if there is a failure, the optimist feels that yes, this is my success that will come, the failure is the stone on which I can climb, and I can try for more success in life. But a pessimist, from the very beginning, he feels that there is no hope. So it is better to explore your own way. Even if you lose your way sometimes, it doesn't matter. There will be many avenues open, keep trying it. And another thing, it is okay if you bunk a class or two. Of course, professors are here. I'm not advising you to do that, but it is okay. And be sincere to your studies, but not serious. Don't develop a pressure cooker attitude so that you always get pressurized that yes, I have to do this thing, I have to do this thing, so that you get tense, and once you are tense, you don't perform well. So be sincere, but at the same time, enjoy life, enjoy the surrounding, and you will see a lot of good things are there. And as I told, life will not give you all the things that you always wanted. Maybe you may get the second best, or you may get something which you never opted for. But make best use of that. What you have today, if you can make use of it the best way, then tomorrow is going to be better. But if you cry, if you start crying over something that you missed today, that missed thing will not come, and your tomorrow also will not be that rosy. So keep that in mind. And coming to the academic side, the BBA, and specifically in India, it is the graduation, what we call, that gives you access to all the entrance level professional fields, including be it engineering side and BE or BTEC. Gets on here for civil services, you get the chance after doing a graduation. In BBA, you have this special thing to grow in the business line. But let me tell you, people normally feel that what the Professor Naik was telling about the CGPA, the ranking, the merit, that will give you the entrance only, but at the same time the survival and also getting into the good job if you want, or even doing good business. It all will depend on your, what I say, street smartness. Books will teach you, professors will teach you, academically you may be strong, but your survival in this competitive world is going to depend on you, how you are going to apply that knowledge in practical field. And there, your street smartness will help you much better. And these days, as we know, we baby boomers got married to our job, and then we got married perhaps for the second time to our wives. But you people belong to a generation where you don't think in terms of a long-term employment. So for you, what matters is the employability. And for the employability, it is your skill, attitude. And attitude is what it makes a difference. And once we think in terms of good business leaders in you, leadership basically is an attitude. And if you feel whatever job or whatever position you have, not necessarily the corner office of the CEO, not the big position or the big title, if you can impact your customers, your people around you, people inside and people outside, with the position, whatever you have, with the whatever job, if you can influence, if you can impact, then you have the leadership ability in you. Try to hone that, try to develop that, and success will be yours. And again, don't just get satisfied that we exist. Whatever we do, the mundane things that speaks of our existence, can we try, strive, and achieve excellence? Let the world know us, not by our existence, but by excellence. And at the same time, once we grow up as the good sons, good brothers, whatever role we play, good citizens of the country, there, keep in mind that you will be the wealth creators, and we create wealth for the well-being of the society. And the society is not just the people of today, people of tomorrow, those will be coming, the next generation, the environment, and the world society, the bigger society. And you are in an age where we were told in Sanskrit, when a child is born and then he grows up, so there it is said, Lalayat Panchavarshani, 5 saal tak, for 5 years, bring him up, bring her up, and then Tadayat Dasavarshani, then for the 10 years, the parents should tell the growing in the adult set years and approaching the teens, that 10-year period, the guidance for you, what is wrong, what is right. And prapte tu shorose barse. Once you achieve that 60th year, then putram mitram ivacharet. So all of you become friends of ours. So irrespective of the generation gap, let the baby boomers and the millennials, the Gen Y that we belong to, let's be friends, and that way helping hands and growing will be much easier. So here, coming to this institute, which stands on its repute, and it is growing from strength to strength, I wish you a very beautiful and exciting stay here for 3 years. Maybe after that, you may join the MBA course here, many of you, I don't know. So, stay well, grow well, stay blessed. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I reckon it to be my honor and privilege to introduce our guest of honor for the commencement day, Dr. Parag Diwan, Chief Executive Officer at Paradigm Consultants and Resource Management Private Limited. Let me have the delightful opportunity of reading out his brief profile. Dr. Parag Diwan is a noted academician and an established entrepreneur who has built some of the finest institutions in India, including the University of Petroleum and Energy Studies, Dehradun. After 15 years stint at UPES as the founder and vice chancellor, he took up 2 years assignments in laureate international universities in Mexico and Malaysia and helped the universities to start academic programs in the EIT sector. Dr. Diwan comes from a scholarly family and has written a number of books on energy-related subjects and traveled extensively worldwide. He did his master's in chemical engineering from Clemson University, USA, and followed by a doctorate in business management from Punjab University. Entrepreneurship and alternate energy always excite him and is close to his heart. Despite of all his achievements, he still remains young at heart and always keeps abreast with new age technologies. Dr. Parag Diwan has more than 200 papers to his credit and has participated in several national and international conferences. He has authored and co-authored over 40 books on management and energy subjects and has also been a contributing editor to various journals. Currently, he is an evangelist and advisor to several institutions working on the area to transform education to what he calls Education 4.0. with the advent of fourth industry revolution. For the past 3 years, he runs his own consulting firm, Paradigm Consultants, which helps higher education institutions, energy companies, and entrepreneurs. Today, he is engaged with several universities and institutions in various advisory roles. May I now request our guest of honor to kindly address the assemblage. Sir, please.
Good morning, and on behalf of BGU, I also welcome you to this interesting day where you make a transition from the school life to a university life, a college life. It's indeed a glorious day that we all remember. I still get goosebumps when I think of my own transition from the school life to university life, and it has been a great experience. I'm sure at Birla Global University, you'll find a great experience, both the dean and registrar have promised you a great time and great studies ahead. Let me at the outset congratulate you for choosing BBA. And BBA is these days a discipline of choice. We conducted a study about 2-3 years back where we looked into dimensions of MBA versus BBA. And we found that in most of the business schools worldwide, MBA enrollments are either declining or at best plateauing, so there is no rise in MBA admissions worldwide. However, the BBA education or BBA enrollments are growing over a cumulative annual growth rate of greater than 11%, which means there is a huge challenge and demand for BBA. Now we should think why BBA is becoming more popular and why MBA is on a saturated curve. This is because today's generation, that is you, think that you should, after school, get a good undergraduate business degree, work for 2-3 years in good company, and there are many, many opportunities these days available to undergraduate business graduates. And then after 2-3 years of relevant work experience, they should go to a top tier MBA program and then progress the career further. So that has been a strategic or a generational shift in today's generation, which is leading to rise in BBA enrollments and saturation of MBA enrollments. Nobody really wants to go to MBA directly after college, that you came to college after school, and from college you went to a postgraduate business school where you never had a practical work life experience. So in many geographies, especially America and UK, they say that you must join MBA with at least 2-3 years of work experience, otherwise they won't admit you also. So slowly in India, we are also moving to this regime. Another interesting part of your generation to be getting into workforce in the next 2-3 years is that this is the generation who's going to experience the best of demographic dividend. Those of you who have read papers a couple of days ago, from 2018, we have entered into a glorious period of up till 2055, where our productive generation, which is between 15 to 65 years, are far exceeding our generations which seek support from us, which is below 14 years and over 65 years. And historically, it has been proven in many developed economies, this is the period of glorious economic development, double-digit growths. Japan experienced this between 1960 to 2004, and you can see where growth of Japan took them on during those years. So you're indeed very fortunate that you're going to be entering the workforce in one of the most golden period of our economic history. Another interesting thing that you have is, as one of the speakers mentioned, this is the era of Industrial Revolution 4.0. Many of you who have read economics in their high school remember that it was Adam Smith's theory of division of labor which led to first Industrial Revolution, and 150 years have gone by. Now we are in fourth Industrial Revolution. What fourth Industrial Revolution does, it creates a job opportunity which were not known here to before, because everything is interconnected. There is artificial intelligence, there are cobots. Cobots are nothing, robots, but who co-work with you. So there is a term called cobots these days, which has led to rise in BBA education of new kinds of specialization. There have been traditional specializations which were mimicked on MBA education of HR, finance, but these days there are a huge set of new specializations: digital marketing, business analytics, financial technologies, what have you. So some of them have also been offered. I've worked closely with the team at BGU to offer a couple of these new specializations here, and going forward we'll be introducing more. I will not take much more time because I know I have a session with you from 1 to 1:30 where I'll be explaining some of these concepts in a little bit more detail, and also tell you as to what kind of job opportunities if you look into some of these discipline areas. And I look forward to seeing you again at around 1 o'clock. And till then, all the best, good luck, and have a great career. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. I deem it my honor and privilege to introduce our chief guest, Mr. Chandrasekhar Mukherjee, Chief People Officer at South Indian Bank. He is a HR leader with global exposure and 29 years of well-rounded rich experience. Currently, he is the Chief People Officer and Head HR of the South Indian Bank, which has 780 branches, 20 regional offices and 8,477 employees. He was the Group Chief People Officer at Sray Infrastructure Finance Limited and Group Companies of Canoria Foundation, designated KMP from 2017-2019. He also served as the Chief People Officer in National Stock Exchange of India from 2010-2017. Responsible for the corporate human resource function for NSE and its group companies, which are technology-driven organization. He was the Associate Vice President in HR and Branch Head in Mumbai in the companies Bennett Coleman and Company Limited, Times of India Group from 2005-2010, also the Business HR Partner for Response and Head HR Operation for South and West Branches. He was the Head of Human Resource Management, Cabot India Limited from 2003-2005, Head of HR for the Indian Operations and reporting to the MD of the Indian company with a matrix reporting to the Regional Head of HR at Malaysia. He was the HR Manager in Colgate-Palmolive India Limited from 1997-2003 and also the Manager HRD in Usha Limited from 1995-1997. The following are his honors and awards. CII Exim Bank Business Excellence Prize for the year 2013-14 and 2016-17. Best HR Technology Award. Award for Talent Management Organization with Innovative HR Practices. Training Excellence Silver Award. Best HR and Talent Practice in NBFC Category Award. Now I request our Honorable Chief Guest to kindly address the assemblage. Sir, please.
Good morning, distinguished members on the dais, faculty members, parents and the youngsters. Firstly, thank you very much for having me over here. It's an honor, and honestly, my experience pales with all the people sitting on the dais for sure. But the only thing I can speak about is practice and practicality. So I will dwell on that and, you know, speak to you guys on that. Mr. Acharya spoke about generation gap. I would tend to say generation gap is in the mind. I don't think I will have that with you guys for sure. I'm 55, blessed with a daughter. Who's studying in Carnegie Mellon University after working for 3 years. My son has just finished his engineering and going to join CenturyLink, an American IoT company. Married. Why I'm saying all this so that, you know, we relate. Couple of more interesting stuff about me, first. The other stuff which they said is very boring. I'm not Chandra. That's not Chandra what it's all about. I was a national ranked table tennis player, so I played for India. My first job was a sports quota job in Customs Central Excise, then moved to a public sector, gave my examination, all that stuff. During all this period, my sweetheart in 10th standard, Kavita, okay, is still my wife. I'm married, this year is going to complete 30 years. Yeah, So I come from a background, my mother, a Roman Catholic, Italian. I was born in Naples. My father, a hardcore Bengali Brahmin, okay? Ancestor of Shama Prasad Mukherjee and Sir Ashutosh Mukherjee. Yeah, can't get better than that. My wife, a UP wali. The only thing I've told my daughter and son, bhai, ladka ladki se shadi kar le, aur ladki ladka se shadi kar le. Baki problem nahi mere ko. Huh? हाँ भाई लोग को हाँ 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 भाई हाँ but वो अपना वो भी girlfriends देखता है मेरे को बताता मैं भी उसकी girlfriends देख लेता हूँ problem नहीं है मेरे को so now coming you know although I've said this why I'm saying this has got a meaning so that you guys understand certain things First things first, I was a very good student, yes. Very, very good student. Never flunked, nothing of that sort. I actually had a brilliant dad. Can you imagine my dad, when I was playing the Nationals in Bangalore in 1980, I had my ICSC examinations. And that was my last year. I was Indian ranked, I went, played Commonwealth and all that stuff myself. And it was clashing with my ICSC board. My dad told me, Bacha, you got a choice. I said, what? you want, you miss your exams, don't give ICSE. Like in next year, firstly you have to get your national rank, you have to pay the finals, and next year you have to get a first class. कि हमारे ज़माने में फर्स्ट क्लास वॉज द ओनली थिंग. ओके, हम 90-90 मिलता नहीं था हम लोग को उस ज़माने में. नो ना, इफ आई सी माई सन्स स्कोर्स ऑफ 94-96 एंड ऑल दैट स्टफ, आई डोंट, वी नेवर गॉट टू सी दोज नंबर्स. सो दैट वॉज हाउ स्वीट माई डैड वॉज. ही अलाउड मी टू प्ले द नेशनल्स, आई प्ले द फाइनल्स, वी लॉस्ट टू महाराष्ट्र, दैट्स अ डिफरेंट स्टोरी. आई एम स्लोली कैरिंग एट कपल ऑफ स्टफ दैट यू गाइज नीड टू डू. ओके, so when I was at home, my father and mom would tell me, Mukherjee khandan ka ladka aisa behave nahi kar sakta hai, right? When I went to schools like Lamartine or Calcutta, Lovedale, Hyderabad public school, my teachers always told me, you belong to this school, you cannot behave this way. If you go to the mall road or you go somewhere else when you're hosteler, yeah, on a Sunday when you're walking down the road. So we were told that. So every class I thought, when I was in 8th, I said 10th mein freedom milega, 10th mein, 12th mein freedom milega. 12th ke baad, abhi aap log idhar baithe hain, you think you're going to get freedom? The answer is no. Because your sirs are going to tell you, guys, you're from Birla Global University, so you cannot, and actually you cannot. And if you think you're going to get freedom when you become, you know, a corporate guy, oh, then there's no freedom at all. You know? So I am carrying the, you know, heavy, you know, on my shoulders, the name of my organization, so I cannot do that. And I'll try to explain to you with an example, okay? Two examples I've got. Imagine me, okay, you guys are working for South Indian Bank, okay? And all of you are in Bombay, because I know Bhubaneswar doesn't have those pubs, Bombay has those pubs, okay? You see me sloshed in a pub. Okay, and you've got other friends coming in. How would you like it? So can I say I'm free and I can do anything? The answer is no. Yeah, I'll give one more example. Bombay has got societies, so I am a secretary of a society, of my society, housing society. I do some fraud. What would the press carry? Would the press say Chandrasekhar Mukherjee behind bars? Or the press say, a senior and top executive behind bars. Senior and top executive, South Indian Bank is behind bars. And where it will be? On the front page. Okay? My photograph will be small and the South Indian Bank's photograph will be larger than my photograph. So I'm still, please try to understand what I'm trying to say is, I'm still carrying the name of the organization. So I can't do anything which is not appropriate outside my job. So we are carrying a family name, we are carrying a school name, we are carrying our university name, we are carrying our office name. So this is going to be throughout life. So anybody who's telling you you're going to have a free run, he is, you know, I know seniors are sitting here, so I'm not saying what I would say, but the question is, we are not saying the right story. Yeah? And why? Because I always say one more thing. What does the industry look at? Okay, we are looking at well-bred and well-read people. Okay, and when I say well-read and well-bred, I'll tell you what it is. I can throw money if I'm a corporate and get a guy from Harvard also. If I pay $120,000 per annum salary, I get a guy from Harvard to work in my company. But if I pay $120,000, will I get a well-bred guy? What is well-bred is values. Okay? So the question is, the differentiating factor when you're joining or wherever you are is the values. Okay? And what all, I made a little bit of joke of myself. In my family, in our family, we don't compromise in two things, education and value. Okay? So, if my kids are educated and they have the right value, I'm cool about it. Okay? Because where the generation gap comes, I'll tell you where the generation gap is. My father, when I studied maths, Mukherjee khandan ka mukhya the, to jab maths padhta tha, he used to say, maths ke saath music? Man, He's not studying, get out, or I'll get whacked. But today's JNAs, maths ke saath, earphone, music bhi chal raha, or girlfriend ke saath chat bhi chal raha. Yeah? And they're doing it. They're multitasking. So you guys know how to multitask. That's the difference. Okay? So I guess use the multitasking in the right method of the madness. Do it rightly. I heard one of the sirs and seniors saying is, the difference between getting a job and not getting a job, you know, education gets you till the job. Okay? The difference, there is a difference between knowledge and education. I want you all to understand that very clearly. You do not need to be educated to be knowledgeable. Right or wrong? I hope the professors don't agree or disagree. But, okay? So, knowledge and education, education gets you till the interview, but knowledge will get you through that. So, don't use education just to get a degree, because just getting a degree is not going to get you a job. Okay? There would be guys like me on the other side who are going to ask you questions which are going to be, which will test your knowledge. Okay? And when you're coming to any organization, there are three things that people look at: knowledge, skill, and attitude. Remember one thing, the knowledge is what you guys are going to get here. Whether you study here, study in Harvard, knowledge today is almost the same. You can go to the internet as well as a Harvard guy going to internet. So actually, a guy like me is not too worked up on whether you're from Harvard, or where you're from IIM, or where you're from global. Okay? But the question is, what will differentiate you when you're coming there? Okay? Skill. So you choose the right companies that you want to join, because all companies don't give you the skill. Okay? What the biggest mistake you guys do, and especially the placement coordinators, you guys do, and I'd like to tell you a story about it, about my own daughter. So you guys choose based on compensation of the company. That's a harakiri that you guys do. Okay, that's harakiri. Right? Now let me tell you that story where. So because you get the skill in the organization that you work from, and your attitude comes from your family, the school, okay, and the organizations you work for. That's the most important places. And attitude, I'll come to that later. Why attitude? Because I'll get to a technical part of it. But let me tell you an experience of my own home. So my daughter was doing an engineering. People think if you go to Carnegie Mellon, you have to be an IITian. But my daughter's not an IITian. She passed out from PESET. And she was the best performer in Deloitte, USI, front-end coder, digital vertical. So when she got the job in Deloitte, so my mom-in-law, I went home. So I was damn thrilled. So my mom-in-law wasn't thrilled. And mom-in-law is actually, she was then 85 years old. Right now she's around about 90. So my mom-in-law was not happy. I said, kya wa nani? So I call her nani because I know her from bachpan se. So, nahi beta. उसको टीयर टू कॉलेज में मिला, मैं टीयर टू कंपनी में मिला. मैंने कहा आपको कैसे पता? वो सोनू बता रही थी. मैंने कहा सोनू बता रही है टीयर टू कॉलेज डेलॉयट? आई सेड ओके. सो वी ट्राइड ब्लैंडिंग डेलॉयट बिकॉज डेलॉयट इज पेइंग ऑन कैंपस 6 lakhs, टीयर टू कंपनी, सॉरी. ओके, सो गाइज प्लीज. सो I worked for Colgate-Palmolive, which is the cream de la cream company that anybody can wish for in his history, life, and for an HR professional. I have gone to campuses where we were day zero. Okay? Today, Colgate and any FMCG company is not day zero, is day three. Okay? It's very unfortunate. It's because of compensation. Imagine a person joining banks, private equity firms, for marketing roles. Whereas you know, learn nothing in marketing, where you learn marketing maximum in FMCGs. Okay? There are people who join technology companies because they pay more, but not an FMCG for HR. So you need to know which are the roles, which are the organizations that are going to give you the competencies, which one of the sirs was speaking to you about. Okay? Both functional competencies and behavioral competencies. So you should know whether your skill has got ticked, your attitude has got ticked, because you need to just work in the right places to get the right attitude also. I don't want to name organizations where you will work and you will learn how to manage the balance sheet. Manage, quoted words, manage the balance sheet. Okay, you don't learn the right things. So John, please join the right organization. I've also made mistakes, and I've made mistakes in this big old age of mine. Okay, I don't want to name the companies. Some of the people sitting on the dais may, looking at my biodata, may understand that, and you'll see the shortest stint there. Okay, so please, for heaven's sake, choose companies that will give you the skill and get you the right attitude, because that is very, very important that you need to do. Now, some of the sirs did touch upon it, but I'd like to tell you again with my own small little way of joking a little bit. You guys need to be, if you want to be successful, if you go to history and see the people who have been successful, either successful politicians or successful corporate guys, have been all multifaceted people. What do you mean by multifaceted? You having other hobbies in life, doing something else in life. You know why? So I love sports. So what do? Because you can de-stress. So what do? On a Saturday, I play squash. And if my boss has been nasty, I hit the ball as hard as I can and take his name. Tabak ke maarta hoon. Yeah? Patapat maarta rehta hoon. And ye bachpan se karna pada. Aisa nahi, jab public sector mein kaam kiya, jab personal officer tha, to Coal India mein kaam karta tha. To mereko welfare committee mein bhej diya gaya tha. To wahan pehle jaake jhatka laga. 15 rupay ka IDEX ko 30 rupay mein charge karna pada. So, maine bola nahi, yahan nahi kaam kar sakta hoon, chhod dunga. So, सोचते सोचते यहाँ तक पहुँचा हूँ, but सिर्फ एक कर सक, the only thing I can say, I've been dead honest, yeah, but you know, have people been able to push me? The answer is no, but I guess. So you'll have those frustrating moments in life. Today, when you join a job, whatever everybody says, however we come and speak to you, there is going to be a gap between theory and practical, huge gap. Okay, so that gap, and when you go there, please learn with the, no job is bad. Let me tell you one thing. So learn it from the smallest guy in the function department that you are there. How many of you are in hostels here? How many of you have you opted for a mess secretary's job? No, distribute karte hain or they opt for it? Huh? They opt for it. How many of you will opt? Dekho, bahut kam haath aayenge. And a guy like me comes, that guy who opts it is selected. You know why? That's a goddamn difficult job to do. And you learn a lot in that job. However small that job is, you will learn a lot. By being a mess secretary, you will know how to run almost a company. To manage people, manage what different palettes are. Just ask. You know, all of us have got mothers. You know how difficult a mother's job is? When she's in the morning asks for kon kya khana khaye ga, uska answer is like, phew, man. Yeah? One more learning. For any decision that you guys take, okay, no decision is a decision if there is no pain and agony. Right or wrong? Yes, I'll give a simple example to show you how pain and agony it is, okay? Simple decision of buying a car, okay? My surname is not Ambani, my surname is not Tata. So the first decision I have to make, what is the budget I have? I obviously love an Audi, I obviously love a Merc, okay? I obviously want a Maybach, but can I buy? Answer is no. So this is the first pain and agony. After I've done everything of that, okay? I say 10 lakhs is my budget. Then within four members of family, there's a pain and agony. X will say this, Y will say this, Z will say this. Right? Then you have to take one decision. After all that is done, the final decision on the color, where the wife will have a huge role to play. Okay? So there's pain and agony even buying a car. So if you're going to think that you guys are not going to have any pain and agony, okay? So any decision that you make will have pain and agony. It's not going to be a rosy world. That's what I'm trying to say. Okay? But you guys actually can do it because you guys, sorry for the language, but you guys rock. Okay? So you guys are rock stars. So you can do it. But have the right attitude, which sirs have been saying here. That's very critical. Okay? Nothing is impossible. So if you think your course is tough, so let me tell you what my daughter does in Carnegie Mellon. Okay? Carnegie Mellon is supposed to be an Ivy League college. Getting in is not easy. She actually studies or works till, on an average, 11 to 12 in the night. With minus 20 degrees, she's in the college. So the first thing they write and tell you, please take your, because when you go for a master's, you can't stay in a hostel, you have to stay outside. So they tell you, please choose a house or flat which is going to be on the bus route. Okay, and the bus drops you, and in the minus 20, you have to walk. The universities there are huge. So you have to walk about 3-4 kilometers, but she's there. So if you think, so anything that you get is not easy. And that's over there, education is totally different. It's totally assignment based. And some of us were talking of analytics, artificial intelligence. There, every person who submits his projects, there is an analytics that happens and it is checked for anything matching and the person is thrown out. And do you know what the pass marks are for a Carnegie Mellon to pass after getting in there? Guess? 70%. You have to get minimum pass mark of 70%. And you can't fudge. So whatever you give a project, the same project to 20 people, 20 people are doing different. Cool? But for sure when you pass out from there, you get a minimum salary of $1,20,000. That's huge, I guess. So basically what I'm trying to say is, you guys have it in you. You guys can do it. And trust you me, please, please, please respect all your teachers the way you have respected your parents, because they are the people who are actually going. They are going to be your father, mother. They may scold you, they may tell you things, but they are telling it for your good. Okay? And I'm saying again with a lot of humility, a lot of experience I've gone through it. Okay? You need to learn from them, ask from them what they can do. Okay? Ask them as many questions that you can. Okay? I guess that's where there is a generation gap, because today's kids, I was hearing a video of Mr. Mukesh Ambani, and that was something great. Mr. Mukesh Ambani can say that I listen to my friends of my children and I love their contrary view that they have. Okay, so we should have contrary views, and I guess your professors will appreciate when you ask questions which are not there. In my days, nobody appreciated that. I used to get that. Jada question puchta class mein, bacha. So, I guess, but you need to take care. You need to ask many questions. You'll have lots that you have. Because the corporate world is a big, bad world that you're going to get into. Okay? Well, it's corporate world, or some of you want to do business. It's not going to be easy. And even more difficult with the way regulations are coming. Regulators are coming with a ton of bricks. So if some of us thought we had free rides, so yesterday you read what happened to Amrapali and what's going to happen to future. So we need to understand. So boundary walls are going to be, it's just like playing a game of football. There's a boundary wall and you know we need to play within the boundary wall. So these are stuff that is there. I just thought I will share with you some of them. One more thing that I would like to also share is, people, when we hire, we are looking at team players, not individual players. Yeah? Please, please learn the art of first being friends within yourself. Today when you're going out, the biggest generation gap is the external world is a multicultural world, multi-ethnic world. If some of us have our biases, please leave the biases home. There is no more biased world outside. It is just a couple of politicians who are making the biases among us. There is no biases. And people are looking at teamwork, which is very critical. And so first learn to do teamwork among your friends. Make as many friends as you can, not from your community, but outside your community. Whether it's you live in a certain place of Bhubaneswar, a friend is there, go to some other place. If it's certain town, go to some other town. So ensure that you do that, which is very important. So I think I'm more or less done. So unless you guys have got some questions for me, I always love to take questions. Happy to take questions from you guys. Best of luck. It's a great beginning. Keep doing what you have done. Okay. Like some of the sirs just say, scoring marks is important. I will not again lie, because there's lots that is, you know, when we recruiters come, we look at marks or we look at things which I normally are not very comfortable. But because you, when you're going to a campus, you've got 100 people, so you look at some cutoff somewhere and look at what's that. Organization are looking at psychometric tests, organization looking at analytics, organization looking at communication skills. Okay. And some of us make a mistake of not looking at ourselves or being presentable. We are very smart looking, but we are not presentable. Okay? What do I mean by that? So if I go to an interview, should I wear a very garish looking tie? Yes, no. Huh? Why? No. Because the interviewer gets distracted from you when he's not listening to you fully. So you want him, his or her attention to you. So you should be smartly dressed, okay? But do not distract the person. It's very, I've seen many places, many colleges, people do not look at the way they, you know, turn out. Meetings, interviews, I'm feeling very hot, okay? I would love to come in a shorts, but have I come in a shorts very honestly? No, because it's not the occasion. I'll go back to basics. Every caste, color, creed, religion has got dress for an occasion, okay? So I will always, although I'm from Allahabad, I've done most of education, so I'm biased toward Amitabh Bachchan, but that's not the case. But there's a difference between Govinda and Amitabh Bachchan, right? Govinda knows to wear only red shoes, blue shoes, yellow shoes on every occasion, but Amitabh Bachchan will wear dress according to the occasion. So please, okay? Finally, etiquette and manners. You know what I tell my son? Today's day, previous yesteryears, the differentiating factor of getting jobs was which college you passed out, because it was difficult to go to Harvard or a better college, so you can do it. Today, that's not the differentiating factor. The differentiating factor is the well-bredness. Okay? How many of you would say, when we go to an interview, the trick of the trade, when the sir gets up, the person in front shakes your hand and says, have your seat. How many of you would say, after you, sir? How many of you would open a door for a lady? Whether the lady is your junior or a senior. Again, look at Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. If it's a lady, however young, small, big, he will get up. He will not sit. Even when a junior artist comes, he gets up and offers a seat. Because that's what we have been taught in all culture. Hamare ghar mein bhi ye Bharatiya Sanskriti mein sikhaya gaya, European culture mein bhi aisa hi hota hai. So please, these are things that we miss out. We think if I get my 100th percentile, I'm going to get a job. It's simple. Will you make a person an MD if he is lousy looking, can't speak? Yes, no. He doesn't dress well. Okay. So it's not that. It's every job has got its various nuances. So if you are working as a doctor, would you wear an Armani suit? The answer is no. But if you're a private equity guy, you have to wear an Armani suit. Because you're talking to people at Taj Lands End and the corner table and cutting a deal who comes in an Armani suit. So if you go to a media company, you will be astonished. And again, a tip, I joined there, I had people like Mr. Pradeep Guha, the dawn of media, Bhaskar Das, I used to work for them. So they would reject a person who wore a black pant with a brown belt. Okay. So if you guys are aspiring, if you guys are aspiring for certain jobs, certain places, please be mentally prepared. Many of us are not mentally prepared. It's, you may think working in a multinational is easier or tougher, or public sector easier, tougher, or a family-run business easier, tougher. Please choose according to what you can do, your value systems can do. Because not all places that you can do. Please choose. Okay? We make mistakes there. So, unless you have questions, thank you very much. God bless you. And anytime, any help, more than happy to support you guys. No questions? Thank you then. God bless.
Thank you so much, sir, for your wise words. I now request Dr. Parmeshwar Nayak, Dean, School of Management, to administer the Pledge of Honor Code. And I kindly request the audience to rise for the same. Thank you.
Not audience, only students.
I kindly request the students to rise for the same. Thank you.
Not senior students, only the students who have been admitted this year. Please read after me the honor code. As a student of BBA, Birla School of Management of Birla Global University, I take the pledge that I will strive to act with honesty and integrity. I will respect the rights and dignity of all people. I will care for others' safety and will avoid any kind of verbal and physical violence. I will provide truthful information to the university about my personal background. I will not fabricate or plagiarize any information with regard to the curriculum. I will always act in a lawful manner and not participate in any unlawful activity. Such as ragging, indulging in consumption of intoxicating substances. I will not seek, receive, or obtain an unfair advantage over other students. I will personally uphold and abide in theory and practice the values, purpose, and rules of the BGU Honor Code. I will report all significant violations of the BGU Honor Code committed by members of the students' community to the authorities. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. It is my privilege to introduce our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sudhakar Panda, the first Vice Chancellor of Birla Global University, retired as a professor and head, Department of Analytics and Applied Economics from Utkal University. He worked as a distinct faculty in IIT Kharagpur in Department of Humanities and Social Sciences, guest faculty at Vinod Gupta School of Management, IIT Kharagpur. He joined School of Law, Kitt University as a senior professor. He has also served as director, Rourkela Institute of Management Studies. He has worked as a professor in National Law University, Odisha. Professor Panda has been the chairman of State Finance Commission, Government of Odisha, expert member of State Planning Board, member of State Farmers Commission. He was appointed a member of State Council for Higher Education, member of State Audit Advisory Board, member of State Level Eligibility Test, Maharashtra and West Bengal. He was the member of National AIDS Control Organization, member Senate for Fakir Mohan University and member of Ramadevi Women's University, Odisha. Our Vice Chancellor has also been associated with the Central University, Odisha. Professor Panda has written 7 books, out of which The Potato and the Pauper and Indian Economy in 2030 are the most popular ones. He has a number of publications to his credit in both national and international journals. He was felicitated by the Honorable Governor and Chancellor of the Universities of Odisha for his contribution in teaching and research in the year 2012. May I now request our Honorable Vice Chancellor to give his deliberation. Sir.
I wish you a very good day. I wish you a very good day. Thank you. Distinguished Chief Guest, Mr. Chandrasekhar Mukherjee, Chief People Officer, South Indian Bank, Dr. Sarath Acharya, our advisor, national professor, attached to the Birla Global University, Dr. Parag Diwan, Chief Executive Officer at Paradigm Consultants and Resource Management, who is closely associated with the Birla Global University. My Dean, Professor Parameshwar Naik, our Registrar, Dr. B. K. Das, my colleagues, Dr. Ashok Panda, Professor Pulin Mishra from IIT Kharagpur, who is incidentally here, and all my friends, Mr. Dr. Bibu Panda, who will be playing a very key role in the years to come when it comes to your turn for placement. All the distinguished speakers focused on certain important points which are very much related to your academic life. What are these points? The first point, wherever you are, at home or in the school or in the college or in the hostel or even in the office, you have to maintain discipline. You have to maintain decorum. You have to maintain your own respectability before others. If you don't respect yourself, others will not respect you. So you have to maintain your own dignity. As rightly said, all of you belong to the age when your country will be reaping the demographic dividends. I have talked about it a number of times in different audiences. How do you prepare yourself for that? It's not enough that you are educated. Education gives you some qualification. It would not be enough for a job. You must know, because you are intelligent students, you must know how your economy is moving, in which direction it is moving, what the market wants, what are the indicators you are getting from the market. And accordingly, you have to prepare yourself to take advantage of demographic dividend. Thank you, Dr. Dhawan, for empowering us. We are old, we are experienced, but we know what it is. The gap that is there, that is sometimes is created by you and me. This can be simply broken. This simply covered. This can be simply breached. If I know how to connect myself to you, I have to take the first step, because I am an elderly person. I must know what you want. And if I take one step, maybe next step, definitely you come forward. I think we have the best things said on this by our chief guest, Mr. Mukherjee. He placed copious examples from his family, from his parents, from his wife, from his work experiences. And if you have listened to him very carefully, I hope you have done that, you know how each of the words he uttered is important for you. How do you connect yourself? How do you connect yourself to the economy? How do you connect yourself to the office where you work? And this is what you learn something from your home. You connect yourself to mother, to your father, to your brothers, to your uncles, aunties, nephews, nieces. You connect yourself. You know how to connect yourself to them. And once you know how to do it at home, it becomes easier for you, because you have some amount of training in that. As Mr. Mukherjee said, each of you has a family background. You must be proud of your family. Your father may be a big officer or may be a small officer, that hardly matters. You must be proud of your family. You have seen that advertisement? When the girl gets down from the auto, and the office where she is going to join, the boss congratulates her and says, "Why, who is this auto?" "My auto, my father." How proudly she says, "He is my father." So you have to be proud of your family. You must feel proud. I feel proud of my parents. I don't think there is anybody here or there who is not proud of his family. That is the first school that you attained. The first basic lessons which are given to you by your mother, by your father, by your brothers, elder brothers, that you carry lifelong. Sometimes they say things which are very important. They may not be educated, but they're wise. And they know what right things are to be said to their children. So they say it. Very often, we ignore them. We feel that our parents are not educated enough to advise us because we are now in bigger place. No, that never happens. And as Mukherjee has said, how do you prepare yourself for the future? See, he said in a so beautiful and humorous way, so that it goes to your mind, to your ears, and you can immediately observe. But he said many serious things. You are, as students, living and working in the knowledge economy. You have to read. You have to work hard. You have to take notes from your teachers. You have to prepare yourself for the exam. As very rightly said, your teaching, your education is not confined to your classroom or what the teacher says. That's only a part of your education. The rest of your education, you will decide where to take it from, what will be your sources of education. And as Mukherjee has said, you must read books. How many of you read novels? Any, whether you may be management guru, you may be an economist, you may be an administrator, you must have the habit of reading books, reading literature, reading history. That is how you develop your communication. That's how you develop yourself. You express yourself exactly what you want to say. Because if you cannot express yourself before your boss or before your colleagues and even before your girlfriend, you are nowhere. You must know how to express yourself. And I'm not saying this ordinary expression that comes deep from inside. So you have to read books, and better if you have not read, because you have just fresh from the school, read some of the classics in your literature, in English literature, in translations, because you have to develop yourself as a whole, all round developed, scholarly development. That is how you will prepare yourself. You will do justice to yourself, and we will feel proud that you are students of the Birla Global University. And in Birla Global University, there is strict code of conduct. You will be told about this by the dean and by the teachers. And we expect you to abide strictly by the code of conduct. Any violation may invite harsh punishment. I'm not saying it, you know. But then I know you are all good boys, eager to learn, rise in life, to conquer the world. The whole world is yours. So prepare yourself for that. And I'm sure all the distinguished guests here said many useful things. They give you many brilliant tips. Many brilliant tips. And we at the Birla Global University do our best to help you. That's why, as the registrar Dr. Das said, we have been progressing step by step, step by step. And there is no reason why we should look back. In fact, we are now looking forward to 2030-40, what will be the shape of this university? How you are going to cope with the demand, rush of students to get admission into this university? That is how we are planning. So you should plan how you are going to relate yourself to 2030-40 after your graduation, after that post-graduation, how you are going to relate yourself. You have to be serious about your own career. And we are here to help you in whatever way you want, we'll help you. And you can always come to the dean for any help. You can come to the registrar for any administrative help. You can approach Dr. Panda, Bhu Panda, for whatever help you need. You can approach any of my colleagues for any academic assistance, we are prepared to help you, provided you are prepared to help yourself. Thank you. Thank you for choosing the Birla Global University as your destination for your academic pursuits. We hope you will use your time very fruitfully and bring name and fame and happiness to your parents. And we will definitely be happy with your happiness, with your success. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to the felicitation, I request our Honorable Vice Chancellor to present a memento to our chief guest, Mr. Chandrasekhar Mukherjee, as a token of respect and appreciation. I would now request our registrar, sir, to present a memento to our guest of honor, Dr. Parag Diwan, as a token of respect and gratitude. Thank you, sir, for your kind acceptance.
Now we have come to an end of the inaugural ceremony. I request the program coordinator of BBA, Dr. Snigdha Mahapatra, to propose a vote of thanks.
Thank you. Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, Chief Guest, Mr. Chandrasekhar Mukherjee ji, Guest of Honor, Dr. Parag Diwan ji, Guest of Honor, Professor Sarath Acharya, sir, Respected Registrar, Professor P.K. Das, sir, Respected Dean, School of Management, my professors of the dais, my dear faculty members, staffs from the Birla Global University, students of Batch 2019-22, and their parents, members from Meridia. Gratitude is the best emotion, and I, Snigdha Mahapatra, on behalf of whole BGU family, is immensely happy to extend my heartfelt thanks to invited members for gracing this occasion today. Respected chief guest, Mr. Chandrasekhar Mukherjee ji, thank you so much for your presence over here. I know out of your busy schedule, you have got some time for us. Thank you so much. Your presence has really made the audience lively, and seriously, he has shown how the generation gap is lying in our mind, not actually in the age. I hope my students will take it seriously. Thank you so much, sir, for being here. This is my pleasure to extend my thanks to Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir. A true academician by heart and mind can only emphasize the role of knowledge and education to be a wholehearted, holistic person in the development process. Thank you so much, sir, for giving this piece of advice. I'm thankful to our guest of honor, Dr. Parag Diwan ji. Thank you so much, sir, for enlightening the gathering with technology-enhanced knowledge, technology-enhanced education. We are yet to have some more ideas from you. Thank you, sir, for being here. I am also thankful to our national professor, Dr. Saratya Charya, sir. Sir, I have always believed in 90% hard work, and thanks for confirming again that yes, it is 90% hard work that will lead, that will take you to the higher destination. So please be prepared for that hard work. Thank you, sir, for this piece of advice. Respected Register, sir, Professor B.K. Das, sir, you are a constant support. I know, and all of us who have worked with sir, we know, give him a logic and your work is done. Sir, thank you so much for being so helpful for everything we are doing, and thank you for helping us to grow. Our own respected Dean, sir, Professor Parmeshwar Naik, he is a constant support. Say it administration, say it academics, say it anything, we always get a blessing from sir, and you have got the blessing in the form of A, B, C, D. I hope you will inculcate this A, B, C, D and grow in your life. Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving this advice. I'm thankful to Professor Maharana, Professor Mishra, Professor Panda for their gracious presence, Professor Mishra. I'm thankful to all the faculty members who have got some time out of their busy schedule of having classes. They are having the classes and again coming back here to attend the program. Thank you so much, sir. Not only that, I am getting a constant support for all the management of this particular event. Thank you so much, my faculty colleagues, members of staff from BGU family. I must mention our GM, SN Maharana, our campus GM, Suar sir, Mr. Raju, Mr. Reshan, Mr. Sir, Mr. Raju, Mr. Chandan, Mr. Barik, Mr. Pandey for their constant support. I will definitely thank another person, Dr. Bivu Panda. For him, we found such a lovely, entertaining, yet interacting chief guest. Thank you, sir, so much. I know parents are not visible here, but for all of us our information, sir, the parents are sitting in another room and they are having the YouTube streaming from there. Thank you, parents, for trusting us. I know there are some anxiousness. There must be some anxiety that whether you have chosen the right place for your kid or not. I assure you, you have done the right thing, and now let your kids to take the responsibility and prove you right that you have given them a right person, right position. Thank you so much. Dear students, I know we will interact much often. But still, here for the first time, and I will always be thankful to you all for choosing BGU. And I hope you will also often give me thanks that, yes, ma'am, you listen to me. So thank you. Thank you, students. My vote of thanks will not get completed if I will not thank my student volunteers. Sir, with your permission, may I please clap for my student volunteers. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I must thank the Almighty God for giving us this time. And at the end, with the permission from the authorities, I would like to give one piece of advice. And this advice I have taken from Ghalib. गिरते हैं साख सवारे मैदाने जंग में गिरते हैं साख सवारे मैदाने जंग में वो तिफरा क्या खाक गिरेगा वो तिफरा क्या खाक गिरेगा जो चलता है घुटनों पे आई डोंट वांट यू टू बी दैट हु विल क्रम्बल इन हिज ऑन हिज नीज रादर आई एक्सपेक्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू टेक दैट हॉर्स राइडिंग एंड विन योर लाइफ थैंक यू सो मच थैंक यू
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request all the dignitaries on the dais and off the dais to assemble at the Activity Plaza for a group photo session.
A state private university in a green and non-toxic campus with a global pedagogy backed by the Birla legacy and celebrating the varied cultural diversities to create ethical global leaders. Welcome to Birla Global University. A state private university in a green and non-toxic campus with a global pedagogy backed by the Birla legacy and celebrating the varied cultural diversities to create ethical global leaders. Welcome to Birla Global University. A state private university in a green and non-toxic campus with a global pedagogy backed by the Birla legacy and celebrating the varied cultural diversities to create ethical global leaders. Welcome to Birla Global University.